As you can see, the weather today is not ideal for skiing, so I decided to show you the different mounts and accessories for skiing. Over the last few years, I have tried many different mounts. In this video, I will show you which GoPro mounts I find most suitable. I will show you with a few examples how the respective footage looks like and what are the advantages and disadvantages of the different mounts. At the end, I will show you which accessories I use for skiing apart from the mounts and how you could solve possible problems with the cold. My name is Werner, I live in the Italian Alps, and this channel is about filmmaking and GoPro. Consider subscribing if you're new here and have fun with this video. For all mounts and accessories I will show you today, I put a link in the video description. There are basically several accessory kits that contain a variety of mounts. I link in any case to a kit which contains all necessary parts except the pole. Please also keep in mind that there is not the only mount that is perfect for all situations. Rather, it would be important to capture different angles to make your edit more interesting. The first mount I want to talk about today is the typical helmet mount. I would say it's the most common of all GoPro mounts. The helmet mount has a few decisive advantages. One advantage is that you will find all the components you need in the original box, so you don't have to buy any other accessories. All you need is an adhesive mount, usually curved for attaching to the helmet, and a mounting buckle. Be sure to use the original version of the mounting buckle. It is much more stable than the mounting buckles included in the accessory kits. The helmet mount is not only easy to attach, you also don't have to bring big accessories with you when skiing. Although the helmet mount is the most common of all GoPro mounts, it also has a few disadvantages. As I have already shown in a few other videos, the camera is not in an optimal angle due to the elevated position. For an immersive shot that also conveys speed, you want to get the slope, the movements of your skis, and also the horizon in the frame. This becomes rather difficult with a helmet mount. For this, you have to set the angle of the camera optimally, and you should shoot with super view. Otherwise, your image could be just a wide slope and look rather boring. The helmet mount has a few other disadvantages. Although the Hero 7 does not weigh too much, with about 100 grams, you can feel it on your head. Some people find this unpleasant. When using the ski lift, it could also happen that the camera is in the way or you bump into something relatively easy and scratch your lens, for example. In connection with the helmet mount, I would like to show you the next mount, the helmet extension mount. You can attach it to the helmet and capture a few interesting angles. As you can see here, you can capture your face during a descent, for example. Of course, this is not a mount that I would use all the time. It is more suitable for a few unique shots that give your edit a little more variety. In addition to the helmet mount, you can also use a chest mount for typical POV shots. Compared to the helmet mount, the chest mount has a few advantages and disadvantages. The lower position gives you a much better recording angle. It's much easier to capture ski, slope and panorama in the same image than with the helmet mount. You create a much more immersive look. But you also need some experience with the chest mount to set the angle of the camera perfectly. The right angle also depends on your size and your skiing style. Personally, I use a J-hook buckle mount to attach the GoPro to the chest mount. This makes it much easier for you to set the angle correctly. I then press the camera almost all the way back so that it almost touches the chest mount. This way, I actually get an almost perfect shooting angle. Another advantage of the chest mount is that you don't really feel the weight of the GoPro on your chest and that it doesn't disturb you while skiing or on the ski lift. A disadvantage of the chest mount is, of course, that you have to buy it in addition and that you have to put it in your jacket pocket when you don't need it. If you already watched a few of my ski videos, you know that I very often use a pole as well. Since I usually make my recordings alone and without help, I need a pole for all recordings that are not POV recordings. I use a rather cheap pole from Luxbell. Of course, you can also use any other pole for this purpose. In my opinion, the following characteristics are decisive. The pole should be relatively stable, which usually is not the case for the selfie stick included in the accessory kits. The length should be easily and quickly adjustable, and the pole should be relatively long when extended, so that you bring yourself completely in the frame. When retracted, however, it should be as short as possible, so that you can stow it in a jacket pocket. To further improve the angle when filming with the pole, you can also use these small arms. If you attach them to the front of the pole, you extend the pole by a few more inches, and you can also easily adjust the angle of the camera. This also makes it easier to prevent the pole from appearing in the image. Besides typical selfie shots, the pole is also great for taking some unusual angles, which you can use to add a little more variety to your edit. As you can see, a pole has many advantages. The main disadvantage is that it can be a bit cumbersome to take it with you when skiing. It won't always fit in a jacket pocket, and not everyone wants to carry a backpack. If you are filming with a pole, you also have to be careful and make sure that the slope is clear. The whole shooting situation is a bit awkward, and you can't enjoy the skiing so much anymore. If you have a friend with you, you could let him film you with the help of the pole, which makes the whole process much easier. Apart from the mentioned mounts, I also recommend some other accessories for skiing or snowboarding. You should always bring an additional battery with you, as the battery life can decrease considerably in the cold. If it is too cold, that means if the temperature drops significantly below 0 degrees Celsius, it is possible that the GoPro will automatically turn off and cannot be turned on again. It is also possible that it is still working, but that the electronic stabilization is deactivated. In these cases, a second battery may not solve the problem. You should therefore try to warm up the GoPro and the battery in some way. For example, you could take the battery out of the camera and while you are riding the lift, put the camera in one glove and the battery in the other. That's unusual, but you will see it works. To avoid smudging the lens, I recommend that you bring a small bag where you can store the GoPro. Apart from an extra battery and a small bag, it can sometimes make sense to bring a thumb screw wrench with you. Especially in the cold and due to the humidity, it could happen that you can no longer loosen the thumb screw of your mount. This small accessory can then help you. In addition to the mentioned accessories, it would make sense to use an ND filter when skiing to reduce the shutter speed. This is especially important if you want to create your final project with a low frame rate, for example 24 frames per second or 25 frames per second. I will make a more detailed video on this topic another time. But when skiing, I have to admit that I rarely use ND filters on my GoPro, also because I often change the settings on the camera, so I would have to change the filter each time. That's why my videos sometimes have this somewhat nervous look. So let's recap. The helmet mount. Advantages: easy to assemble, no additional load, and already included in the original box. Disadvantages: not the ideal shooting angle, some people find the position on the head disturbing. When taking the ski lift, you can easily bump into something. A chest mount. Advantages: very good shooting angle, not disturbing when skiing. Disadvantages: must also be stored in a jacket pocket or backpack when not needed. The pole. Advantages: you can film yourself and you can create many different shooting angles. Also suitable for follow mode. Disadvantages: must be stored in a jacket pocket or backpack similar to the chest mount when not needed. In addition to the mentioned mounts, I would bring a second battery, a small bag and a thumb screw wrench. The use of an ND filter would also be recommended. And the important thing is that you can create a variety of shots and of course that you simply have fun filming. With this, I would like to say goodbye from the Alps for today. If you liked the short video, give me a like as feedback and I will see you next time.